Regine, what have you learned?
Anderson, we have two new pieces of evidence which would appear to substantiate law enforcement's case that this is the real deal, a genuine terrorist threat. One, officials who are familiar with the matter say that Najibullah Zazi, he is the man at the center of this investigation, a 24-year-old Afghan national who's been questioned for 3 days. This official says he has now admitted having ties to Al-Qaeda. Number two, two sources familiar with the investigation say that Zazi was carrying with him videotape of Grand Central Station in New York when he traveled to New York last week. It was that trip, one day before 9/11, that triggered searches in New York and here in Denver. Searches that sources tell us turned up maps and backpacks. Backpacks, you will remember, were used in the transit attacks in Madrid back in 2004. And tonight we have learned that Homeland Security has sent out an advisory note to law enforcement and transit authorities urging them to be vigilant. DHS says that neither it nor the FBI, however, has any information about the timing, location, and target of any attacks. Back to you, Anderson.
Arjun, a lot to talk about. Do we know, first of all, has this guy been arrested, Zazi?
We don't know that, Anderson. All we've been told is that we should not expect to see him emerge from that building tonight. We do know that an official said earlier today that the feds were exploring what kinds of charges they might be able to bring against him.
Gene, stay with us. I also want to bring in CNN national security analyst Peter Bergen, who's recently back from Afghanistan with us, for more to talk about the Al-Qaeda angle. This story, of course, coming as it does right after an audio tape believed to be from Osama bin Laden. Gene, just on the details of this, the authorities are saying he has ties to Al-Qaeda or connection to Al-Qaeda. Do we know what form of connection that is?
No, they are saying no more about it. They're still being very closed-lipped about this investigation because it is ongoing, Anderson.
Peter, how significant do you think this is? Because, I mean, I got to say, I am, and I think there's a lot of people who are very skeptical when they hear about these kind of raids or arrests. Oftentimes, kind of on further inspection, it turns out to be just a couple of guys sitting around talking who never had any access to any weaponry or anything.
Yeah, well, we've seen a lot of plots, Anderson, which have been really aspirational, not operational, where people are talking about doing things and never really actually implementing anything. This case may be different. One thing is it doesn't seem to be informant driven. It seems to have been driven more by telephone intercepts. That may make this case more real. Another unusual thing is the allegation of a direct tie to Al-Qaeda. Many of the cases in the United States we've seen don't have that tie. And finally, another thing that is kind of unusual about this case, that this is an Afghan. Actually, there are very few Afghan members of Al-Qaeda, and I think this is the first Afghan national who's accused of this kind of tie in the United States. And, you know, the Afghan war, it's surprising, hasn't radicalized more Afghans living in the United States, and this may well be the case in Zazi's case if these allegations are correct, Anderson.
Well, it's so interesting, Peter, because there are media reports which his lawyer denies that he visited Pakistan for bomb training and that law enforcement picked up what they described as deeply troubling conversations from him there. What do we know about how Al-Qaeda operates in Pakistan? A lot of people think they're operating in Afghanistan. As we saw, we were in Afghanistan last week, that they're not present or at least visible in Afghanistan on a day-to-day basis. But in Pakistan, it's another story.
Yeah, in the last several years, I mean, the training camps that Al-Qaeda has in Pakistan are not large scale. They are small houses where you can train, you know, 10, 20 people. As a result of the U.S. drones attacks, I think even those training camps are under a lot of pressure right now. But we have seen, you know, a fair number of Europeans going for training in the last 2 or 3 years in the federally administered tribal areas or people who are living in Europe. If the allegations are true, this is an unusual case of an American actually going, or somebody living in the United States going for training there. We also, Anderson, you may remember there was this guy from Long Island called Venus who traveled there in 2008. So it's not unheard of, but it is quite unusual.
His case was so bizarre because this guy from Long Island goes over there and is able to kind of get access to Al-Qaeda, which makes you wonder how easy it is to actually get access to Al-Qaeda in Pakistan. Gene, are authorities confident that they found everyone involved in this alleged plot? Because, I mean, if they're talking about some sort of Madrid-style bombing, that involved a number of people.
We have absolutely no idea, Anderson, to be frank. We know they questioned a number of people in New York. We know that Zazi's father was brought in today for 3 hours of questioning by the FBI. One has to believe that there are a lot of threads that they have to follow here, and we don't know how many people those threads will lead to.
Peter, it also bears repeating that we have seen a kind of morphing of tactics used by whether it's the Taliban or Al-Qaeda-related groups. We saw it in Mumbai. We saw it in Kabul. We've seen it, I think, in Lahore. Small groups of even sometimes lightly armed people doing multiple attacks at once, not just suicide attacks, not just IEDs, but people kind of taking over buildings and kind of paralyzing a city.
Yeah, there has been a trend in the last couple of years where it's not a conventional suicide attack. It's a group of people armed with weapons who go into a situation probably knowing that they're going to die. But it's not at all clear what Zazi's, if he had a plan similar to that. But the tie to Al-Qaeda is certainly worrowsome.
All right. Peter Bergen, G-Meserve, appreciate it. We'll continue with reporting on it.